Yeah.
All right. Cool find, guys.
I'm sorry. I'm writing this down. And what was it, the actual stats?
It does 2d4 mega damage per clawed strike.
All right. Thank you.
And if you have WP knife, you can, like, you can, if you punch, it just does damage, right?
Right.
You can parry with them if you have a weapon proficiency in knife.
I do. Nice.
And you use those same bonuses, too. So.
Okay, cool. We can be claw buddies.
We can be claw buddies.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. You can come up with this song with it.
We're claw buddies. Wow.
Every time you fight, you just put your claws together. Ding.
We're guardians.
Oh, shut up.
Oh, okay, alrighty. Now you're getting ridiculous. Come
yeah,
on,
don't be stupid.
don't be stupid.
But Patrick, I found a chest.
Found a hidden room.
Glimmer.
All right, stop. Stop quoting the YouTube video and get back in character, bitches.
Okay. That's right.
So,
but my character's not saying.
Inspect the rest of the room thoroughly.
Okay.
You know, yeah. Tom is actually going to put on a pair of those claw bracers.
Okay. So, like, on both hands?
Yeah.
Do they fit over my gloves?
Yeah, they fit. They can fit over your... Because the bracers are large and adjustable, so they can go over top your body armor and your body armor gloves. Yeah, totes.
One more question.
I don't want to hurt Alicia if I'm holding her hand.
But... Yeah, that will probably hurt Alicia.
I won't put them on right now.
One more question.
Alicia's like, you can also just now hold my hand if you don't want to.
Well, then whose hand am I going to hold?
Good point. She says, kindly, patiently.
One more question. Alicia. If I have a gauntlet on each hand, do they work like paired weapons?
Yes.
Oh, cool. Which, by the way, you should also know, Mila, that basically means, just like when I use both my knives, you can attack twice per turn or parry twice. It's pretty nifty.
Oh!
Dang!
Mila can't do that,
because
she doesn't have parry.
She's
bragging.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought... Oh. Wait.
You have a special ability for
No, I don't, actually. It never said you needed a special ability. It just said if you fight with two knives, they are counted as paired weapons.
Oh, no, there's a special weapon proficiency called paired weapons. I thought you had it.
Yeah.
What?
Well, yeah, we'll suss that out later. Yeah. We'll suss that out later.
Well, time to expect this room, I guess. Because I think Inferno was going to say something about
that. No, I was going to say, despite your meticulous look, you see nothing else.
Right.
Of significance.
Right. Okay.
And Patrick seems content with this, and will say, all right, to the last bit of this tote. What do I even call this?
Mm-hmm. It didn't have a sign outside. Mine? The signs outside said mine.
Yeah, we'll go with mine.
Wow, the whole Michigan Works Mining Conglomerate, they're really hardcore about this.
I'll call it a labyrinth. I think that's most fitting.
Excellent.
Mila will take the robe off her head because they're just getting in the way now. She's got a new toy to look at. Mila drops the robe on the ground.
If you want, I can hold on to the ropes. I'll pick up the robe.
Mila's being Mila.
Yeah.
Bar now, robe on ground.
Jesus.
Okay. Let's just I'm just gonna squeeze through right over there. Wow. What the hell is happening there? Whoa. Oh my God.
Just being Kriana. Mila's just being Mila.
He's in the way. Poor Alicia's like, no, Mila, just mm.
cool. All right.
Yeah.
So yeah, back down to where you're going before. That was a profitable little side journey.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So,
great.
Do you want me to refresh your memory as to what is in this room since it was from last session?
Please.
If you like, from what I remember, there was a corpse that was badly beaten, and also a backpack over here.
Yes, that's true. Along with some smashed rifles flung on one corner. And some metal shards and fabric and glass kind of scattered everywhere. Mm-hmm. Oh, and there's some blood by the body as well.
Yeah.
But he didn't get close enough to inspect it.
Okay. Well, I will go close to the backpack.
Okay.
Over here.
All right. You head over to the backpack. It is a leather backpack. It seems to have been kind of ripped in two. There is nothing inside of it. It seems that its contents are the bits of glass and metal shards and fabric all over the room. However, you do notice a little something, which is atop the leather flap, which would have used to enclose the actual pack itself, you do see, as I get to my right layer, you do see an inlay within the leather itself of a symbol that looks like that.
Hmm. Hmm. Hey, Patrick?
Yes?
I'm going to hold out the leather backpack. Do you recognize this symbol?
You don't recognize the symbol, unfortunately. All you can tell is that it seems to have been made by... Oh. Okay. Studying Earth's history, you do know that human beings really like using symbols, especially in a lot of societies and religions and organizations, right?
Mm-hmm.
And there are features, geometrical features of this symbol that is recognizable. So you can infer that it is likely of a human history or history-like origin. What it is exactly, you have no idea. You can gather that it probably isn't something from another dimension. It's very, you know, like those that symbol when you're following that treasure map to do, where that symbol is really just kind of weird and out of this world. This one is a little bit more geometrically familiar, so.
Well, all right then. I'm going to go over to the body.
Okay. Closer to the body, you do notice the blood that was pooled around him. It wasn't just pooled randomly. It seems that this poor being's last breaths were him trying to scrawl something in his blood. And it says, it's just two words, Sarah and Annie Matt, and then it stops. It cuts off. So it looks kind of exactly like that in the Roll 20 window.
Okay. And I'm pretty sure my two languages are Technocan.
It's in American. It's in American.
It's in American.
Yeah.
Huh. That's really weird. Hey, Al. Come here.
Coming, I'm coming.
Come on.
Patrick is going to go towards the pack while this is all happening.
All right. You see the same thing as Tom, but you can do what you wish.
Yeah. I'm going to point at the him trying to spell something out. I wanna take a look at that.
Yeah.
Huh?
I understand. What? So take a look at it?
Yeah. And maybe take a look at the body, maybe tell us if you can determine how he died.
I'm on it.
He was do what you do best.
Oh no, I was so confused. It's like I went to look at it. I'm like,
I understand why you're confused, because I think we went over this before, but I'll highlight it too.
Yeah.
Because you're looking at it from afar there. It seems like the man was crushed to death and that he bled out for, you imagine, maybe 2 minutes before he expired. And once again, yeah, there are kind of rubbings on the ceiling and on the walls, too, of like stone against stone or metal against stone or something is rubbing against this stone, which is really strange because there's no such marks anywhere else.
I see.
But yeah, unfortunately, the man is so badly beaten and his armor is so horribly broken, you know that it's human. By its physiology, it was probably a male. And he died a while ago. Like,
and it doesn't look like he's moved much from the spot where whatever happened.
No. No, this is, for lack of a better word, the crime scene.
Got it.
And give me a paramedic check there, a Squeepy.
All right.
Yeah.
He just got a green bar. Know. That's good,
he
right?
He could have died last year. He could have died 20 years ago. Especially in this place that seems to be not even collecting dust. You can't really tell.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to check the pack. See if there's anything inside.
It's torn half open.
And there's nothing inside.
Yeah. All the glass and metal shards, like, scattered around the floor is probably what was in the contents in that backpack.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I don't even know what's...
I will keep it around just in case.
Sure.
Yeah.
Make a note of it. I'll make a note that you have that symbol on the backpack there. Mm-hmm. That could be important.
Yeah. Hey, Patrick.
Mm-hmm.
This guy tried to scrawl something probably as he was dying. Could you probably take a look at this phrase?
Yes. Patrick will look over.
Mm-hmm.
he will say, Sarah, animation, he's going to think if there's any particular, like, any, like, alpha, beta, gamma, if Sarah is even part of that.
No. Roll me a d20. You recognize the name Sarah from the note that kind of led you to this place.
Right. Okay, Sarah...
I would be sitting there thinking, animation? Maybe some sort of animated thing?
Animate objects, probably. So maybe some sort of golem that we're looking at?
Well, it does look like something hard's been rubbing up against the wall here, so that would indicate something in armor or something with a hard shell, something. And
might be a person's name that is... trying to warn, so I guess I'll just mark this down.
And I can't think of any other words that come even close to animat.
Little did you know that there was an animated antimatter chamber within the temple.
I was going to say, unless he wasn't spacing it well and he was trying to say, and I mat something.
I matter.
Sarah. And I matter.
Okay. Let's stop mocking the dead man.
Fair enough.
I'm just joking. Mock all you wish. He's dead. He doesn't care.
So, if it was definitely a warning, probably the thing that attacked him, and the only thing I can really think of is, like, animated... something. So there is a... I'm thinking golem, but that's just hopeful wishing.
It's not my field of expertise, but something huge crushed this man. And with the animat, I'm willing to bet you're right. Or in the ballpark.
Probably. Yeah. Should we bother continuing on, or should we just call it a day?
If you want... If you think it's a golem, Patrick... Because I heard you say that word, right?
Yeah.
Because there are such things as golems. It's created through a ritual magic. And let me tell you what your character would know about them, right?
Right.
They're created through a magical ritual. They're either typically made of clay or they're made of stone. And they're very, very resistant to pretty much all forms of energy, whether it be magic or psychic or energy or even just good old-fashioned punching in. It does, they're resistant. It doesn't mean they're immune to it. And the golem does have one weakness. Golems will... You can destroy it, you can blast it into bits, but they will reform within 24 hours and continue their task. You do know, however, if you cut out a golem's heart, it will stop it forever. This is like, these are the rumors and supernatural texts that you would have come across, especially magic-based. So, that's what you know about golems, at least. If you have any other things you might think it might be, I can definitely educate you with that as well.
Right. If it is, since there seems to be wizard-like things, it might be an animated weapon or weapons. So it might be a clump of animated, like, hammers or swords or something like that.
Yep.
Well, swords
would be freaky. Oh my god.
That's also in the realm of possibility.
Picture running from 50 hammers just trying to smack your head.
Oh man.
Oh god.
Picture running from a stairway that a boulder full of weapons has just rolled down.
The weapons are the boulder. That's the secret. The weapons are the boulder.
Giving me all these ideas. All right. Anyway.
Oh god, no. So the general consensus is turn back now or continue on. I want a actual vote. Or something.
Okay.
Patrick!
I would just look
like
to Patrick,
us continue
yeah.
on?
Let's see. If it's a golem, we might want to think about, you know, tactically what to do, because it looks like this is sort of within range of it, if we are going across a golem. So we might want to have a plan before we continue, but I would like to continue.
Mm-hmm. Alicia says, pipes up, she says, how fast do these things move? Golems aren't known for their speed. You can't really know. You don't really know. You've never seen one move fast, but they're known as... Golems are known as, like... They're not fast, but they will just inevitably get to you because they'll chase you. You know what I mean? Like,
yes.
They're like slow and steady wins the race type of thing. And Alicia says, well, if they're not very fast, we could probably outrun it. If it is a golem. If it's magic something else. Shit, I don't know.
If it's magical weapons, we would have to find the magic source and stop that. If it's self-propelled, it would probably be on them, just similar to a golem. Let's see. And, as a player, that's all I know, but, yeah. If Patrick knows...
You don't know any more lore than that either. It's pretty basic. Or if it's animated anything... done by a spellcaster, you kill the spellcaster. You get rid of the weapons,
yeah.
too.
Yes.
That is true.
That's,
Well.
Right.
So, tactics-wise.
My suggestion would be, kind of like what Alicia said, run, but in a sort of fighting retreat. In other words, have people set up further back that can take as many shots at it as possible and then move back to another position and take shots at it again.
Well, I would say if it is a golem, and Al, if you still have any more fusion blocks, it will probably not notice these things. It will probably continue its relentless assault, even if it's going to actually blow them up.
While that's absolutely true, and I considered the idea, it also poses a chance of causing a cave-in and crushing us all.
Oh, give me a demolition check.
Okay. I can do that. A really good one.
You think that if you set the explosives far enough away from the walls, there's a good chance that it won't create a cave-in. Oddly enough, the only pillars you've ever come across were those more decorative ones way back in that room with all those ornate designs on it.
Mm-hmm.
And the way these walls have stood up to, like, say, Mila's hammer and other such things, plus the potential for magic, even though that's not an element that you can really factor in tactically, you think you might be able to, if you place these near the center of hallways or rooms, the chances of a cave-in are very, very slim.
Okay.
Like, especially a complete unrecoverable one.
Then Al would relay that, and he'd say, perhaps... one right in the center of this room, as far away from all the walls as possible, and we use a small one.
Well, let's see. If I would like to double check with this for you, Inferno. I know we may not even be fighting Golem, but since we're
that'd be the hilarious thing. But yeah, keep going.
Is explosive damage something that's resistant to?
I mentioned before, it's resistant to pretty much all known types of energy. So that cuffs a force, yes. Remember, resistant doesn't mean immune. Mm-hmm. But anything you throw out at it, it's going to be... It would be resilient to.
Alright, so if we want to cripple it or be sure about it, we might want to use a larger one.
Well,
so like something of dimensions of this room here... That's about 30 by 30. A large one is feasible. A hallway like this, though, you gotta use the smaller fusion blocks.
Mm-hmm. Well, apparently, all I have are smalls and mediums, so...
Oh, then there you go.
Yeah.
Hey, Al.
Hmm?
What about plasma grenades? Do you think that would...
I can pretty much say that if a fusion block won't do it, a plasma grenade should also be okay.
That is correct.
Okay.
That is a correct assumption.
I still have 5.
And I've got 1. So we hit it with the medium and then pelt it with fusion or plasma grenades if it's still standing?
Once it stops, we need to get that heart away from any sort of rock clay that it might be.
Makes sense.
Grand.
All right. Mm-hmm. Okay. Inferno.
Mm-hmm.
Because I wanted to, you know, we talked about this before. Can I do a demolitions check to try and rig one up to blow on command?
See, yeah, we did mention that before. You would have had to get like special fusion blocks, like kind of like C4, where it's command. Like these ones that you got are a timer. Now, you can do a demolition check and try a jerry-rig one with... And, like, what you would have to do, frankly, is sacrifice a radio. You'd have to, like, Michael... what's his name? Burn Notice.
Phelps?
No.
Not Michael Weston?
Michael... You have to kind of Michael Weston it and kind of hook up the explosive to your radio signal. So on your other radio, it causes a trigger... to shock the fusion block and have it detonate, right? There are fusion blocks available on the market that are a timer, but that aren't a timer, that are on command. But these ones, you'd have to like do a demolitions check and try to jerry-rig it. And if you fail, then you might actually just screw up the explosive.
Okay. I was thinking of other ways it could be done, but any way I
could
think
of... What are other ways that it can be done?
Like connect a wire, a live wire to it, and then just set it off by touching that wire... a non-live wire to it, and set it off by touching a live wire to the non-live wire, giving
fair
the
enough,
but either way would determine some sort of... Yeah. Some sort of jerry-rigging. I mean, so but my point was that your method, no matter what I think of, is going to be the same.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yeah. Okay. Yeah, I was just going by based on the equipment that you have. Like, of course, yeah, the wire. That makes perfect sense, but I don't think you have that long of wire just kicking around.
Well, actually, but when I originally bought them, I had said that I wanted to use my demolitions to rig this kind of thing up and to get any equipment I would need to do that because I couldn't actually buy the fusion blocks that are built like that. So I did talk to you about getting what I would need to jerry-rig it. So I
honestly kind of remember that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't really remember it, but next time, just put that equipment on your... Did you put that on your character sheet?
No, I
so next time when you buy equipment like that, please just put it on your character sheet.
Sure.
That way we don't have to go based on our memories, right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But sure, I'll allow it.
All right.
Because I'm not going to fight about it. If you guys remember it.
Well, I'm still fine with it being.
It's not like cheating, so it's
yeah,
fine.
Yeah, exactly the same whatever check you wanted either way. So
demolitions. It'll be a demolitions check.
All right. I'll roll a demolitions. I don't need to do that anymore.
Hold on.
Hmm. Yes.
Now you can roll your demolitions.
Woo! I'm out.
Yeah. Alicia holds Mila's hand, be like, "Hey, let's check out what's see what's around the corner here. I think I saw something."
You guys do know that I don't jerry rig things while it's attached to the fusion block, so we're safe.
They're gone.
Yeah, they're just
they're gone.
It's cool. They're gone.
It's okay.
It's fine.
You're only I'm not gonna say if you fail horribly, you're gonna blow yourself up. That's impossible. It's just
right.
Just roll it. Roll it out. Right. Yeah. Fine. You got not fine. That sounds weird. Yeah. Fine. Whatever.
Yeah,
I mean,
sure.
Yes.
It was fine. Yes.
Yes. Yes. You did fine, and it is ready. It is rigged up for on command.
Alrighty, guys. It's okay.
All right. You guys can come back.
Well, all right then.
So I would like to place it right there.
Okay. So now, where are you laying the wire?
Well, basically just straight.
You don't want to just carry the wire around.
No. I would just lay it straight back, like right here.
Perfect.
So just.
And
like
we'll just say it'll be just a single melee action for you to get something to generate a charge.
Oh my gosh! I can use a neural knife, can't I?
Yeah. Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. What square did you put it in?
I put it right in
here, I'll draw
the
it.
Very center of the room. Yeah. So right there.
We'll make it red for... No, wait. That's always the fire. Fuck it. We'll make it bright blue. No one's going to miss it. There it is right there. Fair enough?
Creative decision.
I think you put it on the GM layer.
I totally did.
I don't see it.
Wow. No one's going to miss it.
Layer. Token layer. Now you can
there
see
you go.
It,
yeah,
bitches.
Yeah.
There you go. All
right.
It's pretty. Okay.
Woo!
All right, you laid down your damn mine. As I laugh evilly.
It has no eyes.
It has no eyes.
Actually, now that you mentioned it, I do kind of remember you saying that. I just couldn't remember if you actually bought it or if it was theoretical. I thought it would be like, I can't remember if you were like, yeah, well, then what's the point? Or no,
it was kind of a finagle. Like, I was like, oh, they don't have it. Well, can I do this? Question mark? You know, one of those things.
We have it recorded, so it doesn't fuck. It's all good. Anyway.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, then. We will continue on. We make sure to run back to this point if we run into trouble.
Okay.
Okay.
Roger.
I'm going to stick more towards the back if we're going to need to run.
I actually think the smartest thing to do would be for a few people to go forward and several people to hang farther back. Like not go forward, split up, but you know what I mean. Like not
now,
everyone.
Alicia's fine with going forward with Mila.
All right.
I am perfectly okay with sticking back here.